Dracula, a Lynchburg man, is going to spend 11 years in prison on child pornography charges. 47-year-old Jesse Leon Coleman was sentenced in federal court today. Sally Delta sat in on that hearing. Sally, he is linked to a much larger child porn investigation.
That's right. Coleman and eight others were charged in February of last year, Lynn, and they were part of a group that received child pornography from a man in Russia. 2010, a man who calls himself Andy Danilov begins distributing child porn. He solicits people interested in child pornography and starts regularly emailing those images.
These images contain heart-wrenching, awful images of children in bondage, of rape.
Other defendants came from Pennsylvania, Florida, Oregon, California, Alabama, and South Carolina.
They communicated a shared interest in child pornography on these websites, and the conspiracy began.
They were charged with conspiring to distribute, receive, and possess child porn.
None of the group members, including Coleman, stopped the flow of these images. Rather, they willingly accepted, downloaded, and viewed these vile images of exploitation.
Coleman received the second longest sentence of the group. The judge said his prior conduct with minors drove up his sentence. According to government testimony, Coleman admitted to several investigators that he had sex with minors while on military duty in 1994. They claimed that while serving in Thailand and the Philippines, Coleman paid between $5 and $10 to have sex with them. And they say he told them he would pick the smallest and youngest.
So I'd encourage people to get educated and to acknowledge that this is an issue, that we really have to face it proactively and not put our heads in the sand and think, it can never happen to me. You know, it happens in places like Lynchburg, Virginia. It can happen anywhere.
Coleman spoke at the hearing saying he is very sorry and takes full responsibility for his actions and will seek treatment. Reporting live in the Lynchburg newsroom, Sally Delta, ABC 13 News.
Thank you, Sally.